Hello everyone, in this video we will be studying how to solve a 4 bar truss element. So this is the problem which I will be taking for solving. So what is the question given is, a 4 bar truss element which is shown in the sketch, they ask us to find out the nodal displacement, stress in each element, reaction at the support. And what is the other data given us? For all the 4 given element, the cross section area is 100 mm square and the Young's modulus is 2 into 10 power 5 newton per mm square. So what is the very first thing we need to check whenever any sketch is given us, whether the node numbers is given in the sketch or whether the element number is given clearly or the boundary conditions, is there any problem? All such things we need to check it properly, then only we need to proceed further. Just we'll have a look on the sketch. The given sketch shows that node 1, node 2, node 3, node 4, where node 1 to node 2 element 1 is given, node 2 to node 3 element 2 is given, node 3 to node 4 element 4 is given, and node 1 to node 3 element 3 is given. If the element number and node number order is given in the sketch, means do not change the order, follow the same thing. Look at the coordinates. At node 1 the coordinates are 0, 0, so x1 and y1 according to the numbers I will be writing. For node 2, x2 y2 is 40, 0. At node 3, x3 y3 is 40, 30, and node 4 x4 y4 is 0, 30. Look at the boundary condition. Node 1 and node 4, it is fixed in both x and y direction. Node 2, there is a roller support, it means it is fixed in y direction, where x direction it can able to move it freely. And node 3, it is pinned, and we can able to see there is a point load at node 3 of magnitude 25 kN which is acting towards down. And at node 2, again there is a point load towards positive x direction of magnitude 20 kN. So whatever I said, the same thing is written here. Now, the very first step in the truss or any finite element method problem is modeling. The same thing I will be showing here, where I will be writing the displacement and the forces with the reactions. So, as we know that each node is having 2 degrees of freedom, I will be writing the displacement as Q. So, for the node 1 it is Q1, Q2, for node 2 it is Q3, Q4, for node 3 it is Q5, Q6, and for node 4 it is Q7, Q8. If you are not comfortable with Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, go with even U1, U2, U3, U4 or any other alphabets, anything is fine. And make sure that you are not making any mistakes while writing the displacements. So Q1, Q2 indicates displacement along X and displacement along Y. Similarly, Q3, Q4 means displacement along X and displacement along Y. Similarly, for other nodes also. Similarly, same logic I will be following for writing the force vector. That is F1, F2, F3, F4, F5, F6, F7, F8. And reaction, which is not shown in the sketch, you are supposed to show that. The same thing like force, how you have written R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, R6, R7, R8. You just write that too also in the modeling. Step 1. After the modeling, the very important thing is the nodal data, where I will be writing for all the node numbers what is the coordinates value given. That is, from the sketch directly I will be copying. I think there is no confusion in this step. Moving to the step 2, element connectivity table. This is one particular step. If you make any mistake in any one point, the whole problem will become wrong. So be careful when we are doing this particular step. I will be doing element wise without changing the order what is given in the question. For the element 1, I have 2 nodes, that is node 1 and node 2. You can take anything as initial node, anything as final node. In this problem, I will be following for the element 1. Node 1 as initial and node 2 as final. Similarly, for all the rest of the elements also, you can follow the same thing. So, for the element 2, I have 2 nodes, that is node 3 and node 2. In this, I have considered node 2 as initial, node 3 as final. Similarly, for element 3, I have node 1 and node 3. In this, I have considered node 3 as initial, node 1 as final. For node 4, I have two nodes, that is 3 and 4. I have considered node 3 as initial and node 4 as final. Even you can change anything as initial, anything as final, but make sure that till the end of the problem, you are following the same initial and final node pattern. So, how to find out the length and what is this L and M, which is nothing but the cos theta and sine theta. I will be just explaining for the very first element, that is for the element number 1. The formula says that LE is equal to square root of x final minus x initial square plus y final minus y initial square. Already in the step 1, we have written the coordinates for all the nodes. So, even in this particular table also, I have written what is the initial node, what is the final node. So, correspondingly, I will be substituting and I will be finding out the length. Now, what is small L, which is nothing but cos theta, it is always x final minus x initial by length of the element. Here already length of the element we found out. So, what is x final, say for example for this one, that is final node is nothing but here node 2, that is x2 minus what is the initial node, that is node 1, the coordinate is x1. So, x2 minus x1 divided by length. So, 40 minus 0 divided by 40 equal to 1. Similarly for M, which is nothing but Y final minus Y initial by length. What is Y final for the element 1? The final node is node 2. So, Y2 for the initial node is Y1. So, Y2 minus Y1 divided by length. So, likewise, we need to follow for all the elements. For element 2, element 3, element 4. So, with this, we will be filling up the table. What is the next step? Element stiffness matrix. So, we have here truss stiffness matrix formula, which says that AE by L, L square LM minus L square minus LM, LM M square minus LM minus M square minus L square minus LM, L square LM minus LM minus M square LM and M square. So, for all the four elements, I know what is A value, E value and length value, and along with that small L value, small M value. Make sure that when you are substituting the negative values, you are taking it properly for the calculation. For all the four elements, element 1, element 2, element 3, element 4, carefully you write down with the corresponding nodal numbers. For example, for the element 4, what is my initial node, what is my final node? I have assumed that node 3 is initial, node 4 is final. So, Q5, Q6, Q7, that is initial node, final node. Similarly, initial node, final node. If you look for the element 3, what is element 3? I have assumed node 3 as initial, node 1 as final. So, what is node 3 displacements? It is Q5, Q6. Node 1 displacement is Q1, Q2. So, like this, after finding out K1, K2, K3, K4, don't forget to write the displacement order, because that will help us to write the global stiffness matrix. So, what is global stiffness matrix speaks? It is assemblage of all the element stiffness matrix, that is capital K equal to, since 4 elements, it is K1 plus K2 plus K3 and K4. So, totally 4 nodes are there, each node is having 2 degrees of freedom. So, 4 into 2, it is 8. So, the order of the global stiffness matrix should be 8 cross 8 and it should be the same flow. That is Q1 to Q8 even in the upside, similarly Q1 to Q8 even the downside. First, you write this one, Q1, Q2, Q1 to Q8, similarly Q1 to Q8. Now, we need to add the location, that is Q1 and Q1. This is Q1 and this is Q1. Just find out from all the four Q1, Q1 location, wherever it is there, just add up everything and write the values for all the location. And after writing, just do check whether it is fulfilling the properties of the stiffness matrix. What does the property says? It's the main principal leading liner should not have any negative value. You can able to see here there is no negative value. Since it is a open truss, obviously the like last location, the zero should come. It has come, so it is right. And it should be a symmetric matrix. Yes, it is a symmetric matrix. And it is a banded matrix. You can able to see here the last two is a banded. So, basically it is fulfilling all the properties of the stiffness matrix. So, whatever we have done, it is right. The step 5, step 6 is the nodal displacement vector. So, all the four nodes in the proper order, from the ascending order you can follow, that is Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, Q5, Q6, Q7, Q8, that is node 1, node 2, node 3, node 4. Similarly, for the fours also, F1, F2, F3, F4, F5, F6, F7, F8, you can follow wherever The force is given correctly, you write with the direction. Plus is the positive, minus indicates